Well, hello. My name is Harold. And today, I will be talking about this episode of the FIFA 20 Career Mode. In today's episode, we will be playing four games, where one is a quarter-final of the Europa League. One is against Arsenal. One is... What's the next game? Another Europa League quarter-final. But that would be the second leg. And then the last two are Premier League matches. Now, as we go into this Europa League game against Stade Rennais, which I do know has some fine caviar, we are obviously very, very even to Stade Rennais, as they are a very strong French team, but as we are in somewhat good form, we were tipped to be the favourites at the Molyneux. I'm done with this. I don't know why I did that. Basically, first game against Stade Rennais. We play against the French side. All right. Stade Rennais, a decent side. They beat United, and we've lost to United, but we've also beaten United, so it's not that hard. And obviously, if United are portraying their real-life form in this game, then, I mean, beating United is pretty easy. So, we'll see what happens. It's going to be a really tough game. The French side travel to the Molyneux, so, yeah, we'll see what can happen. See if we can make it to the semi-final of the Europa League in our first season. Adama finding Doherty. Doherty finding Adama. Adama finding Doherty. Doherty finding Jota. And what a save! And it's Adama. Oh my god. Well, what a save that is. And that is just brilliant. As Jota. Oh my god. That would have been nice. It's the last chance of the match. It'll have to be cleared. Oh my god, Vallejo, what are you doing? Oh my god. He just missed that. He did just miss that. Well, that was a shit game, wasn't it? Yes, it was a shit game past Nimrod. It was a really shit game, to be honest. Neither team did anything. It was a stalemate. It was a 0-0 draw. One of the first, I think, of the series. Is it the first? It could be. It was a really shit game. But Vallejo, Jesus Christ, he got lucky. I mean, how did Mbaye Yang miss that chance at the end? But yeah. And you can always tell that it's a shit game, because it's got to 3 minutes 20 of the video, and normally a match takes 5 minutes, and we've gone through press conference, we've gone through the lineup, we've gone through the match, and now we're in the press conference, and we're not even at 5 minutes, so yeah, that's not a very good game, if you can tell by that. But our next game would be against Arsenal. Now, last time we played against Arsenal, oh no wait, last time we played against Arsenal was a 0-0 draw. Well, we've had 2-0 draws then, but Arsenal obviously a very good side on paper and in real life. And we'll just look at these stats here: 28 appearances, 29 appearances for Aubameyang and Jota, and 3 goals for Aubameyang and 5 goals for Jota. That is 2 players who are tipped to be very good, but have been struggling this season. But if you do look at the Arsenal side, it's a very strong side, and that is Nolito. Yes, the ex-City and Sevilla player is starting up front. Nolito, don't tell me that's the ex-City player and like Seville player, because that is just amazing. Anyway, does anyone see that stat as well? Aubameyang and Jota, 28 and 29 appearances, Jota 5 goals, Aubameyang with 3, that is just awful. Anyway, let's try and win this game. Lopez, that's yours, mate. Lopez just died. Can someone check if he's alive? That was literally death. Okay, that's a yellow. Can we check that? Can we check that again? Yeah. He literally kills Lopez. Shotta. Costa. Shotta. Oh, that's beautiful play from them, and that is a foul. And that could be... Oh, it's a second yellow! Pepe's off! Yes! Pepe's off! Oh, wait, no, calm. I'm calm. I think that could be a second yellow. And that could be a second yellow for Nicolas Pepe. Oh, no. No, it's a straight red... It's a straight red card. Not even a second yellow, a straight red card. I mean, Jota looked like he got shot, but it was a definite red card. Ah, that was disappointing. Nelson, that's beautiful from Nelson. He skips past Maitland-Niles. Nelson against his old club. Oh, hits the post. No. Neves, Jota. Neves! Oh, saved. Tomori, nice, cleared away. Aubameyang. And, oh my god, it's a good chance. We're gonna have to clear it. Oh my god! Oh my god, what is Lopez doing? I wasn't even controlling him then. Oh, it's another 0-0. Alright, you know what, guys? I'm gonna play 6 games today. I'm gonna play 6 games. I don't care. Alright, you know, I don't wanna make you suffer with another 0-0. Because the only thing that happened in that game was Lopez made like 2 good saves and there's a red card, so yeah. Sorry, guys, about that. Oh, fuck! I did that again! Shit, sorry, guys. Yeah, so at the end of the game for the mistakes, because in this episode, you're only seeing. 5 games instead of 6. I did promise 6, but trust me, this episode does actually get a goal. So yeah, 2-0-0 draws in a row. That's probably the first time it's ever happened this season and on this series. Obviously, because there's only been one season on this fucking series, you fucking idiot. Jesus. But yeah, a very, very... I don't know how to say that. Arsenal in 4th, and obviously we're striving to get top 4. Arsenal in 4th, if we did win that game, we would actually have a very, very good chance of going in the top 4. But we're still in 8th, but we have 2 games in hand. I mean, that's ridiculous. And we do actually have, in 1 week, 3 games. And all of them in the Premier League, which is just ridiculous. We have Sheffield United, we have Bournemouth, and we have Everton. Everton is going to be played their next episode, along with some other games. But going into Europa League quarterfinal, I felt confident. You know, yes, we've had 2 0-0 draws, but to be honest, a 0-0 draw, it's not awful in the Premier League right now, but we do need to get just that one away goal at Stade Rennais and it will be fine. But we are getting tired and tired and tired as it's coming down to the literal last stretch of the season. After this game, it will be the semi-finals and we've got 6 games left of the season in the Premier League. So yeah, literally in the last stretch of the season. And obviously our squad, taking over the squad, I did say the first thing I wanted to do is actually get a good backup squad. Not just some 5 players who can come in and come in out. I want a full 11 on the bench because we just need that right now. And well, coming into the game, Jimenez was starting. Right, so Jimenez starting. I felt like I haven't given him enough of a chance recently. And although I do love Cutrone and Costa, I feel like maybe we needed that vocal point on the start of that in the first leg anyway. So yeah, let's hope for not another 0-0 draw like we have done in the last 2 games. So Nelson gives wide and it's blocked again. Moutinho crossing it in and Jimenez scores. Yeah, boy. What was that? Ooh, Jimenez actually scores. Wow. And it's 1-0. Get in. So we score. Jimenez. I told you. We played him. We needed that focal point. And he outjumped. Oh. That could be an own goal. But I'm going to give it to Jimenez. And yeah. He's celebrating. He gets the goal. And yeah. 1-0 to Wolverhampton Wanderers. He's on his third Europa League goal. Oh fuck. I just forgot how to commentate then. Shit. Jakob Johansson. And his chance now. And Bai Yang. Oh my god, what defending is that? Oh my god, no way. What the fuck am I doing? Fuck's sake, Gibbs White. Yeah. Well, how close can two teams get? Really, really cracking time. And in the midfield area is really important. Yeah. They've done that today. And they've gone through with growing confidence. And Bai Niang as well. We're in such bad form at the moment. Oh my lord. We come crashing out of the Europa League. That was depressing. Yeah, it was awful defending by me. I just want to say sorry about that. It kind of was my fault and EA's fault. They just made him run, Cody run really fast and into Niang, obviously smashed it in. It was a brilliant finish anyway. I mean Lopez couldn't do anything about that. Yeah, it was a really good goal. But Jimenez did score. That's the only positive I could literally take out of this game. But yeah, that was frustrating. Obviously I wasn't too happy in the press conference. I said it was bad performance, and it was. We played well in the first half, but it was just a bad performance. Oh, we didn't win the Europa League. The low, very, very low continental success of winning the Europa League, and we didn't win it. Like, guys, oh god, that's actually quite bad. Shut up, alright, I'm doing well with Wolves. I think we're doing more than well with Wolves. We're doing really well. We're in a solid 8th place with 2 games in hand. We're challenging for the top 4. We got to the Europa League quarterfinal, which, if you told a Wolves fan, they'd be getting Europa League football. They'd win a Carabao Cup this season. And they got to the quarterfinal of the Europa League. I think they'd be pretty happy. And they'd have the best offensive stat going into this game, playing against the worst defensive stat, or the worst scoring stat, I can't remember, but playing against Sheffield United, they are bottom of the table, and surely, we can get a win here. Right, so we're in a pretty bad form after an absolute terrible loss, basically all my fault, after some awful defending by Connor Cody and me, but we'll blame it on Connor Cody. And, yeah, we really need to get back to good form. I just burped as well, so... yeah, let's go. Johnny. Back to Nelson. Oh, Nelson, that is such good pace from the young right left winger. And that's a foul, and that's a penalty. And it should be... It's a yellow card. But, yeah, definite penalty. And get in now. Who is going to take it? Diego Costa, get off this penalty, my son. I never... Oh, my fucking God. Okay. That was close. For some reason I knew that I was going to hit the post. I just felt like it. But oh well, we scored the backup. What did the keeper just do there? Okay. Well, I have no idea what just happened, but it's 1-0 on Neves' return. So cool.
Costa. And here's Jota. And Jota chips it over the keeper. Calmly as you like it. A good ball by Costa. And Diego Jota scores. What? No, no. Can we just... okay, that was dodgy. What just happened? Okay. Well, I at least I've scored a chip. What just happened? Scores. Oh my god, I thought. And oh my god. And it is full time. So full time scores 2-0. Neves and Jota, the two Portuguese players, link up to score. And does that mean Sheffield United in a relegation battle? I feel like they are. But yeah, it was a good performance, so yeah, I'm not complaining. Good bounce back. Yep, I'm pretty sure we did relegate Sheffield United, or they already were relegated, I'm not too sure, but I looked at the league table after this and I was like, god damn, they're struggling. They were on like 16 or 18 points, and like 18th and 17th were like on 30. So yeah, I think they were already relegated. I need to burp, but I'm not going to, because I am a professional guy. Oh no, that was a bad burp. Anyway, so yeah, a very good win, a very good bounce back, and yeah, it is gutting that we're out of the Europa League, because it was a very good storyline. Although not playing against the best teams, it was a very, very fun sort of side project where I'd have good form in the Europa League but never in the Premier League, but now it's just strictly the Premier League. And yes, we are focusing on that for the rest of the season. Our last episode will be the last episode of the series. Can we get top four? Well, we are unbeaten in a lot of Premier League games right now. I'm not too sure when we last lost, to be honest. Well, that was it. That was a burp that was meant to be coming out. Anyway, yeah, we play a weak team against Bournemouth, and obviously last time we beat Bournemouth 2-0, and we just want the same result here. We just need a solid win. Last time we played Bournemouth, we won 2-0, I think, so let's just hope that our resting, not rested players, but, you know, these players don't play that much. I don't want to call them the B team, because there will only ever be one B team with the amazing strike partnership of Lassina Traore and Connor Chaplin. Oh my god, that just brings back so many memories. That just brings back year 9 memories where I was scared to tell YouTube about my age. I know what I'm talking about, but it's a good chance. And Kutrina! Okay. I wasn't going to put in that whole thing about Connor Chaplin and Lucina Traore, but Katrina gets one of, I think that's his first start in the Premier League, and he scores a goal, so, you know, I'm not complaining. That was crazy. Oh yeah, if we win this, by the way, this is a really long clip, if we win this, we go up to, fifth, so... So we're in 8th, we win it, we go up to 5th, so that's kind of crazy. And he plays it to Neto, the young Portuguese player, as Gibbs White finds Cutrone, and Cutrone, ref, that's a pen, and it is going to be a pen, and getting a penalty, and Kelly, he's a young left back, 6'3", gives away the pen, and it is going to be, yeah, I'd say that's a pen. It's going to be hopefully 2-0 if Cutrone can slot it in and get his second goal of the match, and he does.
very calmly, Patrick Cutrone scores the goal and makes it 2-0 against Bournemouth. That's his second goal. And yeah, that's good that Cutrone scored. I'm just happy that he scored because he might be our striker next year. We might sign someone, who knows. We've struggled for goals this year. Maybe it was Cutrone all along. And Jimenez wins the header. It's Cutrone. Finds Jimenez. That's a brilliant pull from Cutrone. And Raul Jimenez scores a wonderful goal with his left foot. And Raul Jimenez gets the goal. And he does the timber celebration. And it is 3-0 against Bournemouth. Gets in. Brilliant pass by Cutrone, who gets an assist and two goals. But Raul Jimenez, nothing you can do, the keeper could do, Ramsdale could do, because that is just a brilliant finish right into the top corner. Such a weird way he hit it, but Raul Jimenez, Cutrone, Costa, they're all scoring now. That's, why can't they just score when, like, why can't they just score when we couldn't score? That's what I'm trying to say. I don't know what I'm trying to say, okay? Raul Jimenez, Shalmutinia, and Cutrone finds Neto, and Neto gets another, well, I think that's his first goal of the season, maybe his first goal for the club, but Neto scores the goal, he kisses the camera, he just moves the camera and just rubs it into the Bournemouth fans. But Cutrone is literally on fire. Two assists, two goals. That's a 10 out of 10 performance, but a very good finish from Neto as well. And yeah, his first goal of the season. Everyone is scoring now, and it is 4-0. So yeah. Anyway, full-time scores 4-0. Really, really good performance by one man and one man only. That is Patrick Cutrone. Has not been good for much of the season. I didn't really like him. I sent him out on loan for a short loan. And, well, he gets two goals and two assists in this game. So, yeah, brilliant performance by him. So, yeah, good performance by the whole team, actually. And you're probably wondering, why did I add that last part of that sentence? A 4-0 win against a very good Bournemouth side. I'm not complaining. A clean sheet, four goals scored. But obviously you have to focus on Patrick Cutrone's performance. Two goals, two assists, and he won the penalty that he scored from. So yeah, a brilliant performance by Patrick Cutrone. And overall, really, I also thought that Dendonka played really well. And Jimenez also played well, bounced off Cutrone really well. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy this video, please do leave a like and subscribe. Follow my Twitter, @imrod_742. And remember, the last episode of the season is tomorrow.